Hi, this is RichTexBox. In this video, I will show you how to add, read, clear the text in this text box, and at the same time, how to set the margin and how to enable the spell check in this text box control. So, unlike other controls like label and text box controls, they have properties called content and text to set the text. But when it comes to RichTextBox control, it has property called document. This document is of type flow document class, and this flow document contains multiple blocks of paragraphs, and each paragraph may contain multiple lines. So for adding text to RichTextBox control, first we have to create the flow document instance, and after that we have to create the paragraphs. And finally, you have to set that flow document to this text. For that, we will see it in example. So for this project, add a window. Name it as RichTextBox demo. Take a RichTextBox control. Take three buttons. In each click of these buttons, we'll do each of the operation, adding, reading, and clearing. First, name these buttons as accordingly what are the operations. So for the first button, I am naming as add text. Second one, read text. Third one, clear text. So in the add text button click event, we will add text to RichTextBox. As we discussed in before, first we have to create the an object of flow document type. So for the flow document, vjf doc, go to new flow document. Next we have to create the paragraphs. So paragraph vj para 1, new paragraph. Next we have to add lines to this paragraph. For the obj para 1 dot inlines dot add new, I'm adding text as first paragraph, after creating paragraph, we have to add this paragraph to flow document. So for that, obj dot dot blocks dot add obj paragraph. In the same manner, I am creating another paragraph, obj paragraph 2. Here I am adding second paragraph as second paragraph. So after creating an instance of flow document type, we have to set it to RichTextBox document property. Go to obj fdoc. So let us see whether it is adding any text or not. Now run it. And if I press add text, see here the two paragraphs added. When you see this, there is a lot of gap between these two paragraphs. We can decrease this margin by setting the resources properties, like we will see it in later. Now I will see how to read the text from this text box control. So for reading, we will use textRange class, and we will specify RichTextBox document dot content start and content end. Then we can get the text in RichTextBox. So in the button click of read text, we'll take a message box. We'll show that text in message box. For that, new for that, first create an instance of TextRange. TextRange, which is equal to TextRange. Specify the RichTextBox dot document dot content start from RichTextBox 1 dot document dot content end. So we'll show the text in message box, message box dot show widget dot text. Let us see whether it is returning text or not. Now run it. Just add the text to RichTextBox. Now we press the read text. We get the first paragraph and second paragraph. So for reading text, we can use TextRange. So our next step is how to clear the text. So for clearing the text, we have to clear the document.blocks.clear. Here RichTextBox contains text as different documents, and each document has different blocks. So for that, we have to clear all the blocks, or we can also use this code also. So in the click event of clear text, write RichTextBox 1 dot document dot blocks dot clear. Now run it. We'll test it whether it is clearing the text or not. Add the text, read the text, okay, clear the text. So here it clears the text. So our task is next setting the margin. And you see here is a lot of gap between first paragraph and second paragraph. We can set this margin in the resources section of RichTextBox. We can set this margin as 0, then we will get a low space between paragraphs. So we can implement this. So I am writing here. You can mention it in resources section. Further, RichTextBox dot resources. Sorry, sources. In that style, target type. X type paragraph. In this we can use set property name is margin and value is 0. This is usage of styles and resources. Can see it in later videos. Now run it whether it is giving low space between two paragraphs. See, here is low space. Now for adding spell check or enabling spell check, how to enable spell check. For that, spell check dot is enabled equal to true. So this is how to add, read, clear the text in RichTextBox control. You can find me, you can get tutorials on how to set ASP.NET ShakerBlocks for .in. Thank you.